This is a low profile distributor cap for the HEI distributor. It's basically two different caps made into one. The HEI distributors are originally going to come with this kind of cap, which has the coil in the cap. And when you take that cap off, of course, you're going to have a connector laying there, which you'll need to connect to an external coil. There might be times where you need something low profile like this to clear a supercharger, an air filter, a low hood. It also neatly arranges the cables to each side of the engine for a cleaner, neater look. Another advantage to this distributor cap is that you can use a lot of different kind of coils when you have them externally located. You can have a coil that's much more powerful than the one that would have to fit on top of this distributor cap. But in order to make this kind of distributor cap, you need two different caps. You'll start out with a cap from a say a 1976 Chevy pickup with a straight six 250 motor. This kind of cap is actually going to bolt onto the same kind of distributor as this one. But of course, this one's not going to work on a V8 because you only have six terminals on it. So what you're going to want to do is literally cut this top part off. And when you cut it off, of course, you're going to be left with a big hole. You're going to want to get a file and file it nice and flat. You're also going to want to go around with a file and trim some of this ribbing that was sticking out before. I got it trimmed down. So of course, now you got the base here. You're going to want to insert the upper cap into it, which is a cap from a say a 1998 Chevy pickup with a V8. You know, you might ask, why not just use the distributor that this cap came on? Well, that kind of distributor is computer controlled. That distributor all by itself is not going to trigger your coil to spark. It doesn't have the timing curves built into it, but you're going to have to modify it. You're going to have to cut some of this ribbing here, and then you're going to have to cut it about halfway. So, of course, I got another distributor cap that I've already modified. This one, you can see I've cut the ribbing there, and I've also cut it about halfway. When you cut it, you want it to be 22 millimeters from this flat part up here to the lower part, 22 millimeters, both sides. And then after you do all that, you're going to be able to insert this upper part into the lower part. Of course, you can't just put it any old way. You have to make sure it's clocked right. It has to be timed right. You know, all caps, you're going to see that this... that they have a tooth here. That's so that you align, you clock the distributor right on the distributor. You see this rib right here. You're going to want that rib to be right here in relation to the top part. Now when you insert the top part into the lower part, you see this screw right here. You want this screw right here to be right between the coil terminal right here and number six. You want to look at it dead on. You're going to want to move it until you get that screw dead middle between those two terminals. And then you push. You want it to be a snug fit. But before you glue it, you're going to want to make sure you're at the right height. You don't want this to be too high. You don't want it to be too low. Too high, it's going to be too spaced away too far from the rotor. If it's too low, you might hit the rotor as it turns. So you're going to want to measure from up here to down here. You want it to be 57 millimeters. If you measure from this flat part up here to this flat part right here, it's going to be 16 millimeters. But from up here to down here, 57 millimeters, and you're going to have a good cap. You're going to want to glue it. You don't want to get water or dirt inside your distributor. I've noticed that the best kind of glue to use is this JB Weld Plastic Bonder Black. This kind of glue is strong. I've noticed it lasts many years. It dries nice and smooth. It doesn't dry lumpy. And of course, on this distributor cap, I've already run it on a car. You can see that it's already been glued. You know, when you put these two caps together, you're gonna see that you got some gaps that you're gonna want to fill in. I prefer to use brass terminal caps, that way they last a long time. Okay, wiring. Like I said, when you take that upper part off your distributor, you're gonna have a plug here. You're gonna want to connect two wires. You know, these distributors, they have three wires. You're only gonna use two. You're gonna use the positive wire, which is red here, and then you're gonna want to use this brown wire. This middle wire is not used. It's just ground, chassis ground. Don't confuse coil ground with this chassis ground. This coil brown wire right here is a switched pulsing timed ground. This is what fires your coil, the spark from your coil. So don't confuse it. I mean, you got different coils that you can use. There's a you can use a conventional coil if you want. I already got the this coil wired up. You know, if you don't want to cut this connector off, you can always crimp on some spades that you can insert into that connector. And of course, this positive side of the coil is going to go to the positive right here on this connector, and then this negative coil is going to go to the brown wire on this connector. And once again, you're not going to use this middle wire, just leave it disconnected. You'll also notice that I got another wire coming out of here, and of course you're going to want to plug that one into your to power. You know, you're going to have this kind of connector that originally went to your distributor cap there. Of course, you're going to unplug it there, and then you're going to plug in, you know, you're going to want to insert that power right there. That way you get power to your distributor and you got power to your coil. Now, this kind of coil, if you use this kind of coil, the problem is with using this kind of coil is that this coil cable that goes here, that comes out of this right here, that coil wire that comes down that set is not going to plug into this kind of coil. You're going to have to cut that connector off and crimp on a different kind of a boot and connector here. You can see this one here. I cut it, like I said. I crimped on this boot and terminal, and of course this one's going to plug into this coil. Of course, if you don't want to deal with that, you could always use a coil from that same 98 Chevy pickup, and you're going to get this coil. This kind of coil, there's nothing wrong with it. Nice powerful coil. When you get your wire set, this kind of coil cable will plug right into this coil, which is nice. You don't need to modify any kind of coil wires on this one. However, you'll need to get the connector for it, which is special. And you like this connector here. You can get it at a junkyard, you can get it at an auto parts store, or online. I bought this one on eBay. And of course, this connector is going to plug into this coil real easy. You'll notice there's three wires coming out of this one. The pink wire is going to be your power. And then you're going to have two white wires. These two white wires are actually connected to the same thing inside the coil. That's coil negative. They put two cables on here so that you can have one that'll go to your tachometers. You know, your tachometer is connected to your coil negative. And of course, you got another. This one here with the black stripe is actually going to be your coil negative, which is going to, of course, go to your brown wire on your distributor. And of course, you're going to want to wire this one not only to your distributor, but your power wire from your vehicle. Okay. There's a different kind of cables you can use for your distributor cap. There's basically two kinds. You're going to have one kind that has a 90 degree to your spark plugs, and then you're going to have another kind that has a straight boot to your spark plugs. If you got a small block Chevy, you're going to want to use the 90 degree connector to it. That's what small block Chevys use. You know, your 350, 327, 305 motor is, you need a 90 degree plug cable to it. If you want 90 degree, you're going to want to get your spark plug wires from that 1998 Chevy pickup with a 5.7 or 5.0 motor, and then you'll get your 90 degree cables. If you want straight boots to your spark plugs, then you're going to want to get cables from that 1988 Chevy pickup, but with a 7.4 454 big block, and then you'll get straight boots to your plugs. That's what you want with a big block. You're also going to want a straight boot for any other motor, you know, a Pontiac, Oldsmobile, Buick, Cadillac, a Ford, a Dodge, all of those, you're going to want a straight boot. So then you would get these kind of cables from your 98 Chevy pickup with a big block in it. Okay, and you can get straight boots. Of course, you're going to want to get your rotor that's going to fit inside your distributor cap. This one is from that 1976 Chevy pickup with a straight six 250. You're not going to use the rotor that came in this kind of cap because it'll hit in that low profile distributor. So you're going to want to use this cap. You don't need to modify it. It's good to go the way it is. Now I need to talk about firing orders. When you install this distributor with this kind of distributor cap in your engine, you're going to want to make sure your engine is at top dead center at the beginning of the power stroke at cylinder number one, okay? Let me show you these diagrams, these firing orders. You know, you got all these different firing orders for different engines. You know, these different engines have different firing orders, and of course you're going to arrange the cables differently depending on what kind of engine you got. And then, like I said, when you install that distributor into your engine block, you're going to want to make sure your rotor is facing this direction that this white arrow is showing. You know, like this is a Chevy engine. When you seat that distributor down in your block, you want to make sure this rotor is pointing that direction. If you don't, then it's simply not going to work. Okay, it's just going to, your distributor is going to be clocked way wrong. It's not going to be facing like this, like it should. So when you install that distributor in your block, make sure that rotor is facing this way. Of course, you got different engines, you know, you got a Pontiac or Oldsmobile right here. You're going to want your rotor facing that way. If you've got your Buick nail head and you want your rotor facing that way, you got different engines. You're going to have to follow these diagrams. Of course, once you install your distributor cap according to these diagrams, you're going to have to time it with a timing gun to get it right on. You do have two choices when you install this distributor. You can either have it like this, or you can have it like that, 180 degrees. The reason I'm telling you this is because there might be times when this vacuum advance right here might be in the way of something. Maybe it hits something. In that case, you could actually turn this distributor 180 degrees, and of course your vacuum's going to be on this side, but your firing order is still going to be the same. You're still going to have the same firing orders according to that diagram. You'll still need to clock your rotor the way it shows on the diagrams, but you can have this two different ways. It's the same thing, you know. The only difference is your coil, like if you have it this way, is going to be on your driver front versus having it over here on your passenger rear. So that's in case you have some kind of clearance issue. You have two choices to mount this. One last thing I want to talk about is, let's say you got one of those later model computer control distributors. You know, there's HEIs that don't have a vacuum advance, and they'll have a computer controlling the advance. And a lot of those kind of distributor caps won't have the hook type hold down. They'll have a screw holding the distributor cap to the distributor. In that case, what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to literally cut these hooks off with your with a strong cutter. And then after that, all you're gonna need to do is pull out these screws. And then you're going to insert screws that have 3/16 by 24 thread. And you would probably have to be longer, of course, so that they'll... And you might even have to use a couple of washers so that that doesn't sink down into the holes there. That is in case you have one of those less common distributor caps, distributors that use a threaded screw instead of a hook to hold on this distributor to the distributor cap to the distributor. And there you go.